We're here at the Spring Texas Reptile Expo in McQueenie, Texas. I'm here with the famous, amazing, sexiest, that's a word on the street.
Yeah.
Pete Memikos.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah, so, geez, Pete, I mean, we go back a ways.
Yes, we do.
We found each other on the highway on a dark and stormy night.
Looking for snakes.
Yes, of course.
Yes.
That was a funny night. Who were we? But we actually also were looking for a man. Do you remember who the man was?
I don't recall, I was with Brooke.
Were with Brooke. Oh, yeah. We were looking for Brooke.
He wasn't there at the time. He showed up later.
Yes, yeah, so, yeah, that was really funny because that was Brooke before Brooke agreed to be enslaved to a cell phone. And he's like, oh, we'll find each other. Yeah, let's go. You're coming from New Mexico, I'm in Texas. We'll run into each other.
And oddly, we did.
We did.
Which was the strangest thing.
So you were with Brooke.
I was with Brooke.
And we also ran into Jerry Salmon.
Yep, and Jerry's here at the expo also.
Yeah, it's a reunion. So wow.
I was asked to tell a story about an individual.
Let's hear that.
Well, basically, back in the late 80s and early 90s, I worked exclusively with the dwarf monitors, the ones that come from Australia. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there was Acanthurus, which are the Ackies, and then the Kimberley Rocks, and so on and so forth. And I had about 6 or 7 species.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I happened to run into somebody who was kind of the competition, if you will.
Gotcha.
But he was from the West Coast, and I was from the East Coast.
Okay.
You can imagine those little things that happen between East and West.
Clash of the Titans!
Well, anyway, we happened to be sitting down at the International Breeders Expo. At the time, it was in Orlando.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a group of people, and we're talking about this. And he begins to tell me that Ackies, if you have a group of them, will change sex.
Oh! So they're part clownfish?
Oh, there's no, to my knowledge, they're not, you know, hermaphrodites, and they don't. Long story short, I kind of refuted that idea, but I did realize that it was really a sales tactic. So he was trying to get people to buy multiple groups in the hope that these were going to change sex, and they will have a breeding group. Well, when I challenged that, I just happened to be sitting down to a vet next to me, who was the young lady I was seeing at the time, and I kind of looked to her and said, well, is there any way? And she kind of implied that, well, when they're in the egg and before they hatch out, the sex has already been determined, and she doesn't know of any reptile that changes sex. Now, amphibians may have the capability of doing that,
right.
But it became a point of contention at the lunch that particular day. And with that said, I still had a very strong customer base for what I was doing at the time. Oddly enough, after all these years, I'm going back to the dwarf monitors. So it was a very interesting lunch that we had.
Very interesting. So you've worked with a huge range of species, including cats and a number of reptiles.
Reptiles and exotic mammals. We've worked with lemurs, marmosets, tamarins, tyras, kinkajous, things of that nature.
Mm-hmm.
But my love has always been with the reptiles.
Yeah.
There's never been a day in my life from childhood, and my mother has pictures of me at 5 years old holding box turtles and frogs.
Wow.
So this has been embedded into my blood from a very long period of time. But yes, I've worked with different python species. I've worked with different colubrid species, monitors in the past. Now I'm going back to the dwarf monitors, and quite a few tortoises.
Yes.
That's one of the things that I'm allowed to do here in Texas and give them as natural as habitat as I can outdoors.
Right.
And so they seem to be thriving, and I seem to feel that that's going to be a very lucrative and a fulfilling thing for me to work with the tortoises also.
I feel like it's in the best interest of the animals for you to work with them where you are, because I mean, they're essentially free range animals that are.
This is very true, because you know, you're taking some of these animals and you're forcing them into a indoor captive you know, habitat, and you're not providing them with the natural sunlight, and I don't really care what kind of light bulb or whatever, there is nothing that's going to duplicate the sun. So when you're dealing with your iguanas species and your tortoise species and, you know, a lot of your lizard species, they really do need that natural sunlight. So I literally, literally left New York to come to this habitat and this climate so that I could do more outdoors. So my iguanas, they go outdoors, and all of my tortoises, they go outdoors, and everything is outdoor enclosures. And I have a protective steel fence that goes, a solid steel fence, so nothing gets out, nothing gets in.
Awesome. So how long is it gonna be before you get me a pair of red ackies? Or you can just give me two, one might change sex.
Well, you know, I can get you six and you'd have a breeding group, I'm sure.
Hell yeah!
I'm sure. But yeah, you guys are on the target for them.
Awesome.
And when are you coming to Texas to live?
So, we're in transition right now.
Well.
Very soon.
You will be welcome with open arms.
I love you too. Yes. We have family. All of you guys are like our family here in Texas. We love the show. We love this area, and yeah, it's definitely our long-term goal. We're talking to lenders, looking at properties. I am contracted to the job I'm in now until the end of May, and so yeah, we're moving.
Well, like I said, we'll be welcome with open arms, and anything that we can do for you, like you said, we're family.
Awesome. Well, that was Pete Memikos, everybody. Yeah, he's kind of an elusive creature, so.
Well, they call me the legend.
Oh.
So.
And humble.
Yeah. Just a little bit. I still have that New York in me.
Yeah. All right, I hope you guys like this one, and we'll see you guys soon.